All right, I know it's not Christmas yet, but one of my favorite all-time movies is A Christmas Story. One of the funniest parts is when they were trying to get Randy to eat meatloaf.
Meatloaf, double meatloaf. I hate meatloaf.
And I gotta tell you, when most meatloaf looks like this, I can't blame Randy at all. And the dad was a real understanding dad. Remember what he said? I'll get the kid to eat. Where's my screwdriver? My plumber's helper. I'll open up his mouth and I'll cram it in. This is my jacked up meatloaf. You're gonna love it, and even Randy would love it.
One of the things that makes this recipe unique is besides a pound and a half of beef, I also use about a pound of sausage. And with my onions that I add to the meatloaf, I've always felt like the worst meatloaf had onions that always felt kind of raw. So what I actually do is I cut up the onions pretty finely, and then I actually saute them. I think it's important that when you're using onions that you saute them, which brings out the caramelization and the sweetness of the onion. While sauteing them, I also add about a tablespoon of garlic to add a little bit of kick. And now that they're caramelized, we're ready to go. Then crunch up about a half a sleeve of whole wheat crackers to where they're pretty fine. And then to the crackers, we mix in a little bit of egg and cream to create almost a paste, for lack of a better word. And once you stir up the paste real well, the next step is to add it directly to the meat. Oh, first, I forgot about the kicker, the most important flavoring, Fuzzy's kicker. And then we do add a little bit of salt, we mix that in. And then we mix it into the meat itself. And it takes a little bit of time. You gotta meat it. You gotta put it together, make sure it's consistently done. I do a trick. I put mine on buns, which kind of soaks up some of the grease. Here I'm applying a little bit more kicker on the outside. And then the next step is to apply some nice barbecue sauce. You can make your own sauce, but we've got a very nice mild fuzzy sauce that works perfectly for this. So we coat it up pretty good. And now out to the grill.
All right, I've split the coals up for indirect heating. I put a little bit more fuel on. I'm adding some hickory to both sides with that smoky flavor. All right, putting her down, putting the lid on, about an hour and a half. We'll have some smoky, jazzed up, unbelievable, freaking out of this world meatloaf.
Meatloaf is out, nice and caramelized, smoky flavor, smoky scent all through the house, perfect.
The flavor of this meatloaf was perfect. It was caramelized on the outside with the sweetness of sauce. You had the smokiness and the kick and the sweet onions within the meatloaf itself. You had the firmness of the pork. I mean, it was just absolutely perfect. Give this jacked up meatloaf a try on the grill. I'll guarantee you won't be disappointed. And while you're here, don't forget to sign up for our barbecue newsletter. If you're listening to this on YouTube, make sure you rate this video. 5 stars would be great because that's as good as the meatloaf was. And don't forget to subscribe. See you on the next installment of Barbecue My Way.